Los feet of Vasudha Padrana Saravati Thakur. He is known in Krishna Lila's Kunga Vidya Sakhi. When we went to the Astasakhi Kunti, we heard the lotus mouth of Vaishnavas, the glories of those eight different Sakhis. Vasudha Padrana Saravati, he has written the most amazing shastra called Adasa Shuddha Nidhi, in which he is singing the Lord Shrimati Radhika. As he was writing, he said that Krishna himself came and said, "Oh, would you please write something about me?" And he said, "If I'm writing about Shrimati Radhika, you are included in the picture." Because as you know, the speciality of our life is that we are cultivating the worship and love of Lord Krishna with a leaning towards Shrimati Radhika. As it is said, if there was ever a quarrel between Radha and Krishna, and then they would separate, the whole Gaudiya Sampradaya would turn their back on Krishna and follow Shrimati Radhika. So Shri Prabhupada Saraswati, when Krishna was asking him to write about himself, he said, "I have written about Shrimati Radhika as an institution." Then he has written that, "Oh, if I could simply be a broomstick, one stick in a broomstick which is sweeping the kunja of Shrimati Radhika, my life would be successful." Now, there's one incident I remember giving that one Hitali Mansa was ostracized by his spiritual master from the Vaishnava community. Because he had eaten some pepper palm. On the day of Ekadashi, his Gurudev said, "Oh, you should not take grains," but he took grains and also Peter. And Gurudev said, "But you should not do that, for it is lost prashad." So, because he displeased his spiritual master, he was rejected by his spiritual master. But Prabhupada Saraswati gave him shelter. For this, he was boycotted by the Vaishnava community. And therefore his name doesn't appear in Chaitanya Charitamrita and Shastras like that. So, this is between parentheses. Prabhupada Saraswati, he has written extraordinary glory for Shrimati Radhika. As it is said that if one reads his book, it becomes enchanted, it becomes mad of Radha Prem. Because it's extraordinary glory for Shrimati Radhika in the most wonderful way. And expressing the love between Radha and Krishna in the most wonderful way. That they are blessing each other's heart, considering each other more dear than their own life, one to each other. So, this is the type of verses that he's writing about.
I am very ignorant on the subject.
He is coming from South India. He has appeared in the South Indian family. As you know, when Mahaprabhu was doing Chaturmasya in South India, he came to the house of Venkatapatna and spent 4 months in their house. Now their uncle, there were 3 brothers, one of them was Prabhupada Saraswati. Later on he came to Vrindavan and did his bhajan next to Kandyalya who had come this morning. When Mahaprabhu came in South India and stayed in their house, then he converted them from the worship of Lakshmi Narayana to the worship of Radha Krishna. When they were asked questioning, "But how is it that Radha Krishna worship is higher?" Then he quoted a verse, Mahaprabhu quoted a verse of Srimad Bhagavatam, that, "Oh, Lakshmi Devi has been performing austerities for so long to achieve a position in Rasa Leela. By this, they were convinced that, oh, Radha Krishna worship is higher," and they turned from Lakshmi Narayana worship to Radha Krishna worship. Now the question comes, because many times Mahadev has commented on this, that once, as long as one is not established in his rasa, by hearing about different type of rasa, he may be attracted. Yesterday, as he was speaking, if someone is hearing some rasa katha on Matsanga Bhad, he will say, "Oh, this is very nice, he hardly be attracted." If he hears Katha on Sankhya, "Oh, very nice, he will be attracted." But that doesn't mean that by association the change of rasa will take place. Gurudev always explains and stresses that rasa is already fixed. from the Swarup of the Jiva Kapali fix. Given an example that you can plant on the bank of the Ganga so many different seeds, tamarind seed, jackfruit seed, mango seed, indi seed, but they will have the same soil, same water, same sun. But from mango seed you will not get tamarind fruit. From tamarind fruit you will not get mangoes. You will get according to the seed. So in the same way, the Swarup of the Jiva is already fixed. And it is revealed not just by association. When the spiritual master is giving diksha, he's putting the heart in a seed form within the mantra. The knowledge of Krishna's original form and Bhagavad Samhita Rishisha Gyanamsa, the specific knowledge of the relationship of that jiva with Krishna. So according to this revelation, the jiva will, by practice, manifest the soul when it comes to Bhavavasa Padmavapada. No, unlike the other lines where they said, no, Jiva has no Swarup, Guru is giving the Swarup. Here some pandits or Babaji in Vrindavan said, you don't have to come, don't come to Gaudiya Mutha, because their Guru says Swarup is already fixed and it is revealed. Come to us, we'll give you Swarup, because you have no Swarup. It's here that function. But it is not accepted according to our Jiva Goswami Sandhapa, when it is very clearly said that the Swarup is fixed and it will be revealed, but not given by Guru.
In the Krishna Dasa, the Swami has described almost all the Vaishnava life, but he has not written anything about Prabhupada Saraswati. Why? Because Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur told to Krishna Dasa Vyasa, I will give my inspiration to you if you will not take the name and my glory in your and Loknath Goswami also he had to go. So he had only taken the name but not described their lives. Because they were not in entangled with any prasansa, pratishtha, name and fame. Also, some persons think that Prabodhananda Saraswati and Prakashananda are same, but really they are not same. At the time, first one man was Prabodhananda Saraswati, and after some time he became Prakashananda, and again he became Prabodhananda Saraswati. How possible? So it is not possible to break one piece. Especially one thing, you know, Krishna Karanamrita of Bhila Mangal Thakur, he has glorified Krishna and he has glorified Radhika in the servant of, main servant of Krishna. But Prabodhananda Swami in his Rasa Sudhadini, he is a Radha Pakshir. He has glorified Krishna but with the guidance of Srimati Radhika. See, he is most beloved of Krishna. In this way, we know something about Prabodhananda Saraswati. Now, there, Bhila Mangal Thakur, you know, Krishna Karanamrita. At that place, about 700 years, he did austerities there. He did bhajan there, on the bank of Kali River. And after that, after 700 years, Vallabhacharya came, and he gave mantra to Vallabhacharya. and then Prabhulala started in the line of Vishnu Swami, he preached in the Pratyuga. Now, we came to Kalyuga. In brief, Shyamalji will speak about Kalyuga. How Kashyan, how even the last week today, how fast the prayer of Lord Patni, I said you should begin. But very quick, 10 minutes.
Loving Rasa, Radha and Krishna, he told them that Lakshmi Devi performed so many austerities in order to enter the Rasa Lila, but still she was unsuccessful. In one kalpa, Yogamaya came. In another kalpa, Sri Krishna himself came. Seeing her great severe austerities, and asked her, "I'm prepared to give you the blessing that you can enter Rasa Lila, but are you prepared to give up your husband Narayan, as the gopis gave up their husbands and ran to Krishna when he played the flute?" She said, "How can I do that? I'm a Brahmani wife. I can't give up my husband. Are you prepared to make cow dung patties just like the gopis? How can I? I'm a Brahmani." So being attached to her caste and her chastity as her husband, she was not allowed to enter into Rasa Lila and attain the dust of the lotus feet of Sri Krishna, because she couldn't follow the footsteps of the gopis. But that same Krishna, by dancing on Kaliya, we read in Srimad Bhagavatamrita that he was inviting the gopis to actually perform Rasa Lila on the heads of Kaliya. Along with his own foot dust, he attained that sublime foot dust. So the Nagapatis prayed that what Lakshmi Devi could not attain by the mercy of Lord Krishna, he attained it, our husband attained it, so we no longer desire that he dies. When Srila Gurudeva was in Odessa a couple of months ago, he told a very interesting secret. We hear that Nagapatis wanted to now save their husband because he had become a devotee, and they now would be happy to have the association of such a husband. But Gurudeva added something extra, that in order to protect their chastity, because if their husband would die, then some other evil snakes, bad snakes, would come and try to spoil their chastity. So they wanted to remain chaste and pure, so they wanted to keep their husband, now especially that they had become a devotee. Krishna also saved Kaliya's life and blessed him with his lotus foot dust, because Garuda personally slapped him with his wing. And we know that whenever one gets chastisement or punishment by a pure devotee, that's as good as getting blessings from him. Just like Narada cursed the trees and they became liberated. He cursed the Nalakubera and Mani Riva, and they became liberated. So the punishment or chastisement of a pure devotee is actually a blessing. So Krishna saved Kaliya because of the prayers of the Nagapatis, and also because of the mercy that he got from Garuda. So then Krishna ordered Kaliya that you and your wives should now go to Ramanapadvipa. I know that you're pure now, but because of your past, my associates may be afraid. So now you should leave this lake and go to Ramanapadvipa. But Garuda will never hurt you because you have the dust of the lotus feet and my footprints on your head.
¿Qué es?
body purpose is like to marry mother. Into a body purpose into a little common for our Sopranati Mahaprabhu. এখন যখন কৃষ্ণের হাজার ব্রহ্মাণ্ডের ভার আশ্চর্য করতে পারবো না, তার সব মুখ থেকে রক্ত কমি করতে লাগলো, তখন তাহার শরণাগত ও আমার প্রতিবার যাহাকে বলছিলেন সেই একটি, তখন শরণাগত হলো, তখন কৃষ্ণ উপর থেকে মস্তক থেকে নেবে আর নিচে নেবে আসে আর কৃষ্ণের স্পর্শের দ্বারা সব তাহার দুঃখ কষ্ট সব দূর হয়ে তুমি কি কহো কৃষ্ণ, আমি কি তপস্যা করেছিল, কি গান করেছিল, কম তীর্থকে কি তপস্যা করেছিল যে আজকে ব্রহ্মা বিষ্ণু ব্রহ্মা শঙ্কর লক্ষ্মী আর নারদ সমস্ত দেবতা কৃষ্ণের তার মস্তকে তোমার মস্তকে তুমি নৃত্য করেছে অল্প তুমি ধন্য অর্থের কালকে ধন্য এখন কৃষ্ণ কালকে কি তপস্যা করেছিল এখন বিচার এই কালিকাতে দেখা যায় যে কোনো তপস্যা কিছু করে নাই কিন্তু একটি কথা মথুরাতে একদিন নিবাসে না কৃষ্ণ ভক্তি প্রজাতে একদিন যদি কেউ থাকে তাহলে তার ভক্তি আর কি কত যুগ প্রায় 8-10 যুগ না 11 যুগ পর্যন্ত বৃন্দাবন ছিল একটি প্রথম কারণ এই আর দ্বিতীয় কারণ তাহার স্ত্রীগণ পরম ভক্ত আর তৃতীয় কারণ শত্রু যদি ভক্ত হয় তাহলেও তাহার কৃপা ধার করে আর যদি মিত্র বিষয়ী হয় তাহলে ওর পরমার্থ নষ্ট গরু তাহার কোনদিন অমঙ্গল চান তাহার পরে মুক্তা দূর করবার জন্যই তাহার উপরে এইরকম আক্রমণ এই জন্য গরুড়ের ইচ্ছা হলো যে এর মঙ্গল তখন প্রভু ভগবান কৃষ্ণ তাকে ক্ষমা করে দিয়ে আর এরকম করতে সুযোগ মনে রাখতে হবে এতে বহু সব শিক্ষা আছে যে জন্মেতে কৃষ্ণের ভজন হলো না বিষয় সেবা হলো ও জীবনটা ব্যর্থ তার বহু সব এই জন্য খুব সাবধানী পূর্বক এই জন্মে কিছুই না হোক কোন চিন্তা নেই হরি ফজলে জীবনে এত সব ছাড়িয়ার বর্ণাশ্রম ধর্ম অকিঞ্চন হয় লইয়া কৃষ্ণের রসন তবে কৃষ্ণ করে তার আত্মসম চিদানন্দময় সেই অপরাধিত দেহ এই মনুষ্য জন্ম যদি হেরে গেল কৃষ্ণ ভজন যদি না হল জীবন ব্যর্থ হয়ে গেল কোটি 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 করোড় জন্ম পর্যন্ত তার আর মঙ্গল নেই বিশেষ করে এই যুগে যে শ্রী চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু প্রেম বিতরণ করতে যে ব্রহ্মা শঙ্করের লাভ হয় না असी अजाति प्रेम के परिपरे दिए जाते हैं अर्थात भक्तगण तथा पृथ्वी के सर्वत्र घूरे दिए थे कोटो स्नेह करे आदर करे ताके एक दिए दिया किंतु दुर्भाग्य की एवं विषय को ताते जीवन व्यर्थ साधु संग ताके हूँ अपन है कि नहीं के विषय ऐसे दिया मन है यदि कोनो लोग परमात्मा के तकिए हूँ परमात्मा एक ही पौषा नीचे काजे जब व्यवहार करे ताले एक दुर्गति उधर बुद्ध पाल रहा है साधु संग आशे गुरु वैष्णव संग आशे किंतु पृथक करे कुछ निजे पौषा जमा है ताले पौषा जाने पड़ता है कोई उत्पादन कोई चीज पाते कर ऐसे तो तुम्हारा पौषा टोषा किंतु रखते ना समय तीन तीन चर भाई काटे जो दिक्कत था के हमारे दिए जीव आमी भोजन करेंगे तार पर दरकार हुए थे नरसिंह महाराज ने एक बार गुरु महाराज बोले थे हमारा पिता श्रीराम पूरे थे गए श्रीराम फिरलाम तो 140 टका दिखा हो से समय पे बहुत टका उन्हें 40 टका देखे और गुरु महाराज के 100 टका दिए तो गुरु महाराज तुम्हारे जिज्ञासा कर रहे हैं कि कत टका भिक्षा हुई छो हमने इसे खर्चा और क्या बात दिए 140 टका अपन नरसिंह महाराज के डाले महाराज सुनो कोई 20 का दे आपने भरू करके पार करना लेकिन हम इस दो करेंगे तार करेंगे तमन तो खूब रहेंगे सी है जय नहीं कर अगर आपने कुछ देर बात सुना एक दर 20 विषय ने टाटा आमी इस उत्तर करते सी एक बार आपने दिए जाए आप तो प्रथम ही क्या नहीं रहे ना अभी बोल रहा अपना क्षमता नहीं भोगे लगाते भोगे ना लगे कृष्णार्थ सबसे ये सब तो शिक्षा वैष्णव देश में थे के आत्मे ये सब कुछ ग्रहण कर
Therefore, he heard so much Harikatha, but he didn't follow any of it.
Therefore, as Krishna was pounding his head and he was vomiting blood and weeping, then he realized, this person on my head is 1,000 times stronger than me. Oh, what my wife said, this must be him, the Supreme Lord. Therefore, Kaliya, he surrendered to the feet of Sri Krishna. Then Sri Krishna came down off his head and gave some blessing and sent him to Ramadweep, Fiji. Therefore, what austerity did Kaliya do? There are 3 main points. It said, if one spends even one night in Mathura, Haribhakti Pujayati, one is guaranteed Haribhakti. And Kaliya was there since the 4th Manu. Huh? 96 yugas, 24 Mahayugas, Tiri yugas, he was there. So 96 yugas, if you haven't calculated, you can work out how long he was there. Therefore, he's so long he spent in the Dham, Vrindavan, and not only the Dham, but Yamuna. Second cause, his wives were devotees. Therefore, he got so much chance to hear Harikatha, and because of the wives of Kaliya praying to Krishna, then Krishna gave mercy to Kaliya. At first the wives were thinking, oh, if our husband dies, it's good because he's opposed to Bhajan. But when they saw him surrender to Krishna, then they prayed to Krishna on his behalf. And the third reason is Garuda's mercy. Garuda had a fight with Kaliya and pounded him with his wing. Therefore, even though Kaliya thought Garuda is my enemy, Garuda never thought Kaliya was my enemy. The Vaishnava always acts for, in an auspicious way for everyone, even those who desire ill for them. Therefore, there are so many teachings in this Kaliya Lila. We should keep them in mind always. We should understand that in this human life, if we do not perform the bhajan of Krishna, then this life is completely useless. Therefore, Mahaprabhu is instructed, one should give up the constraints of Varnashram Dharma and take complete shelter of Sri Krishna. Diksha kari, bhakta kari, atma-samapan, sei kari, bhakta kari, kori atma-sam. At the time of initiation, when the devotee completely surrenders to Guru and Krishna, at that time the devotee receives a spiritual body like Krishna himself and say, apakataya Krishna chana vajaya. In that spiritual body, one performs the worship of Sri Krishna. Especially we should understand that this very Kali Yuga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this world and he distributed Raja Bhakti, which is rarely achieved even for Brahma and for Shiva. Therefore, that person who gets Sadhusanga like Kaliya but doesn't follow the instructions, that person's life is really useless and they are really unfortunate. How is it possible if we are studying Sadhusanga but still material desires are within our mind? Really, there is one cause of this. We are keeping money for our own material enjoyment. And that money is like poison, so wherever it will go, it will come out in the form of material desires. Therefore, Gurudev told one story in his own life history. When Gurudev was younger, then he went preaching with Pujapada Srila Maharaj, the uncle of Pujapada Srila Bhaktivinoda Mahamudra Goswami Maharaj. So they went collecting, and he won. Well, his disciple Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur. They went collecting it. They collected 140 rupees. Then the 100 rupees came to Pada Gurudev. Then Pada Gurudev asked, well, how much did you collect? The Gurudev said, I collected 140 rupees. Then Pada Gurudev, he called the Pada Srila Maharaj, where is the other 40 rupees? Then the Srila Maharaj, he became very angry. And he threw it, take this. Then Srila Padmavira counted the 40 rupees, then gave it back. And the Srila Maharaj was a little angry. Oh, if you did that, then why would you keep it in the first place? Then Padmavira said, this is poison. That money has come from materialism, it's full of poison. And ordinary bhakti cannot digest it. Therefore, you should give it to me, I'll digest it, and I'll give it back in the form of prasad. Therefore, brahmacharis and sannyasis should not keep money for their own enjoyment. They should give it to Gurudev and give it back in the form of Mahamasha. down to Bihari.
Gurudev told about the Bhaktivinoda, how Bhaktivinoda appeared. So there was a great saint named Goswami Haridas in the line of Nirvakacharya. She was doing bhajan in Nidhuvan, near Sevakunj. So Swami Haridas was very great musician. So he has so much power in singing that he has given disciples Tansen and Baiji Babar, Babar, they perform music in the assembly of Emperor Akbar. So there are so many stories about this. So once King Akbar asked Tansen, if you can perform so nice music, how will be your guru? From where you learn? So Tansen told, if you listen from my Gurudev, oh, you forget me. So extraordinary performance with us. But you cannot go near him with this dress. You never perform music. He only sings for Krishna. So Tansen brought the emperor in ordinary dress. So he approached the king. As soon as they approached, Tansen approached the Gurudev, Haridas. So Haridas told to Tansen, please perform, sing something, what you learned from me. While singing, Tansen knowingly did mistake. While did mistake, then Swami Haridas had to chastise, oh, I taught you like this. So then he took the Tanpura and started singing. So nice he performed, then sang Basant Rag, you know. All these started to, all the animals like deer, peacocks, all started to run there and started dancing nearby. So Akbar became strong seeing this extraordinary performance of this Swami Haridas. So this Swami Haridas was such great devotee. Actually Krishna became greedy, always hearing his kirtan. So once Bhante Bihari came in his dream and told, oh, I am in the fear of the Muslims, kings. I am in this Visakha Kunda, in this well. Please, take out me and serve me. I want to take service from you. So how Swami Haridas to the Bhaktivinoda Deity and started doing seva. So like this, the Bhaktivinoda Deity appeared. So so nicely they are serving, that thousands of people, millions of people, they always gather. So this Bhaktivinoda was very, very affectionate to his devotees. If any devotee asks anything, very easily they give. So once one Brahmin from Bharatpur, a great devotee, he came and started praying to Bhaktivinoda. He became attracted and eye-to-eye conversation with Bhaktivinoda. Then asked, oh Lord, if you will come with me to Bharatpur, I will serve you wholeheartedly. So Bhaktivinoda told, okay, I will go with you. So he granted. So when Pujari gave rest to the deity at midnight, then he arranged a car and Bhaktivinoda came with him. So on the way, going to Bharatpur, so almost nearby Bharatpur, so became like Mangala time. Pujari entered the altar, so no Bhaktivinoda deity is not there. So they remembered, oh, one Brahmin came. He's a great devotee, was praying constantly, long time. Maybe he took the deity. They all went. The Brahmin was, anyway, he put the deity in a pond. And afterwards, there was so much fighting and they brought the deity back. Since then, always they never keep the altar a long time open. Every like minutes they close the altar screen again open, again close. Because they are fear, the deity will go with somebody. But this is the speciality in Bhaktivinoda. Go to Manandir.
Srila Rupa Goswami ke parampara mein Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur hai. क्यों क्यों धार्मिक रूप गोस्वामी द्वितीय रूप गोस्वामी बोले श्री रूप गोस्वामी भोजपुरी भक्ति स्वामी सिंधु आर भगवतामृत कना और उज्ज्वल मणि कना किरण ये तीन जन वैष्णव कना এইটা যারা পাঠ করবে তারা তো বৈষ্ণব পাঠই করে না মানে ধারণ করবে সর্বসাধারণ ভাষাতে সংস্কৃত করেও সাধারণ লোকের জন্যই কিছু তিনি লিখেছেন তারপরে তিনি পাঠ করছে তার তন্ত্রী নামকে একটি গ্রন্থ লিখেছে আমি এই গ্রন্থ পাঠ করব संजीवनी स्वात्मारंभे काम तत्व
তাহলে তার মধ্যে অবশ্যই আসবে যে আমি কোন স্তরে আছি
সাধু সঙ্গ অন্যতমে বৃদ্ধি হয়েছে কিনা, তারপরে নিষ্ঠা হয়েছে কিনা, শক্তি হয়েছে কিনা ভালো করে বুঝতে পারে। আর তারপরে ওই রকমের ভজন করে যাতে ভাব সুদর্শন প্রভাব, আর তারপরে এটাকে প্রত্যেকটি স্তর থেকে নিবারণ করে। আর ভোজের কাদম্বরী কেন না কাটলে তার দপ্তরি বলেন মেয়ে মেঘেতে জল থাকে, জল মানে অমৃত। অমৃত হচ্ছে কি? অমৃতের মধ্যে কি ফল আছে? তার মধ্যে মানবতা কাম ইত্যাদি মহাপ্রভু যে কৃপা সেটি বর্ষা জল, জল না অমৃত, অমৃত এই জন্য তার জীবনে মহাপ্রভু মেঘ মালা